Hi everyone, in this session I am going to explain about the lumbar puncture surgery. So this is one of the most common procedure in the emergency department, and this is of two methods. One is diagnostic and therapeutic. So in order to rule out any diseases, this lumbar puncture is performed, and also to treat any condition, this is performed. So to rule out meningitis is nothing but the inflammation of the meninges. That is, meninges are the coverings of the brain and spinal cord. So to rule out this condition, lumbar puncture is performed. And also to know any disorders of the central nervous system and multiple sclerosis or cancers of the brain or spinal cord. So to rule out the cancers also, lumbar puncture is performed. So this is a diagnostic method of the lumbar puncture to rule out the diseases or condition. And also therapeutic, it's nothing but the lumbar puncture is performed to treat the condition or diseases. The anesthetic medications or chemotherapy drugs are introduced into the cerebrospinal fluid of the spinal cord. So in those cases also lumbar puncture is performed. So it's a therapeutic method. This is a diagnostic. So this is performed to rule out the diseases or condition, or also to treat the diseases or condition. So that's the difference between the diagnostic and therapeutic. So what are the diagnostic CPT codes? So in this session we will see the diagnostic method of the lumbar puncture. So diagnostic is very common in the ED. So diagnostic is again of two classification. It is divided into two CPT codes. So one is spinal puncture lumbar diagnostic CPT code is 62270, and the same thing, but if this procedure is performed under the guidance of the fluoroscopic or CT, so we have to code 62328. So these are the two CPT codes. So we'll see the diagnostic spinal puncture lumbar. So what exactly the physician will do in this, now we will see. Suppose a patient is having any headache like that. So to rule out any central nervous system or meninges, if physician is suspecting the headache is because of any other problem like meningitis or any cancers, so the physician will do the lumbar puncture to rule out this condition. So in this, what physician will do is, to the patient he will give the anesthesia, and then the provider will identify the vertebrae. So these are the vertebrae, right? Lumbar, thoracic, sacral, we have, right? So spinal cord. So in the lumbar region, the second and the third, or else the fourth or the fifth vertebrae, he will identify. Either he will take the L2 L3, or else L4 L5. So he will mark this location L2 L3, or else L4 L5. So he will mark that. So at that location, the physician will insert a spinal needle. Carefully he will introduce the needle into the particular vertebrae wherever he chooses, either the L2 L3 or else L4 L5 location. So he will introduce the spinal needle without damaging the blood vessels. Nearby blood vessels will be there, right? So without causing any damage to the blood vessel, he will introduce the spinal needle carefully into the vertebrae space, and then he will advance the needle. That is, the needle is moved forward into the vertebrae until the CSF fluid will leak out. So like this, a test tube is taken. So a test tube is kept near the needle. So until the flow of the CSF, cerebrospinal fluid, this yellow one is there, right? So this is nothing but the cerebrospinal fluid. So the cerebrospinal fluid is collected in the lumbar puncture. So the physician will insert a needle into the vertebral space, and then until the CFS is leaked from the needle, so he will advance the needle. So the CSF is leaked from the needle, and then he will collect the 8 to 15 ml of the cerebrospinal fluid, and then this fluid is sent to the pathology for ruling out of the meningitis or any other diseases. And then after the after the collection of the CSF, the particular location where the needle is inserted, the physician will flushes the site with the saline solution, saline with sterile saline. He will clean that location and then he will apply some gauze at that particular needle insertion site. So in the spinal puncture lumbar diagnostic, what physician will do is he will remove the cerebrospinal fluid from the spine and then he will collect that in the test tube like this and then send for the pathology to rule out the meningitis or any other cancers like that. To rule out the condition, he will do the spinal puncture, that is a lumbar diagnostic method. So sometimes what will happen in obese patient, the needle insertion will be very very difficult. So in the normal patients, the physician can insert the needle into the vertebra, but for the obese patient it is very difficult to perform this procedure. So in those cases, the physician will use the guidance of the fluoroscopy or CT. See, this is a fluoroscopy. So under this imaging study, he will insert the needle and then he will withdraw the cerebrospinal fluid and he will insert the needle and he will collect the CSF fluid and he will send that to the pathology to rule out the condition. So that's the difference between 62270 and then 62328. So if physician is using the fluoroscopy or CT guidance to insert the needle, so we have to bill this CPT code. If he is not using any fluoroscopy or CT, we have to bill 62270. The method is same, but here no guidance of CT or fluoroscopy. Here the fluoroscopy or CT guidance is used. So these are the two CPT codes. So now we'll see one scenario. Patient is coming with headache to the emergency department and the physician has performed the lumbar puncture in order to confirm that if he is having any meningitis. So patient is having severe headache, so to rule out if at all patient might be having any meningitis, to know whether the patient is having that or not, the lumbar puncture is performed. So what he is doing here, now we'll see whether he is using the imaging guidance or not, or else without any imaging he is doing the procedure, we will check that. So anesthesia is given and then he identified the space between the second and third. So as I told, right, either he will choose the space between the second or third, or else the third or else second, third. This is the second, third, this is the fourth or fifth. So like that he will see the space between them and then he will mark that location and then the needle is inserted by the physician and the CFS is leaked out and this is sent to the pathology. So the pathology result was what? No meningitis. So nothing is there. Whether the condition is confirmed from the pathology or not, the procedure is performed, right? So we have to build the CPT code. So do remember this point, no meningitis. So if meningitis is there or not to the patient, if it is negative or positive, we have to build the CPT. Why? Because the procedure is performed by the physician. We have to build the procedure, right? So we have to give the CPT code. So that particular location is cleaned with the sterile saline and gauze is applied. So here, whether the physician is doing the procedure under the guidance of the CT or fluoroscopy, no, he's not using the guidance of the imaging, he's just inserting the needle and then CSF fluid is removed from the spine. So what is the CPT code? 62270 is the CPT code. Lumbar puncture he is doing. 62270. So this is also one of the common surgery in the emergency department to rule out the conditions. This is performed. So please do remember these points. So what we have learned, the lumbar puncture. So lumbar puncture to rule out the condition and sometimes to treat the condition also, this procedure is performed. And again we have in the diagnostic with imaging, without imaging. So if patient is using, if the physician is using the guidance, so we have to code this one. If physician is not using the guidance of the imaging, so we have to code this one. Simple, the method is spinal needle is inserted and the CFS is removed and collected in the tube like this and sent for the pathology to rule out the condition. So this is all about the lumbar puncture. So if you have any queries, please comment below. Thank you.